Can you book the flight for 9:30 on Monday?
Yeah. Listen.
Hold on.
I'm here. I got to check in the comments. What's your name?
Ahmed.
Hey, Ed. How you doing?
No, it's Ahmed.
Yeah, I heard you first. Ahmed.
No, it's Ahmed.
Yeah. Hey, Ed. How you doing? Jimmy, how are you?
Jimmy. It's pronounced Ahmed.
Oh, Ahmed.
Correct.
That's your first name?
That's my first name.
All right, let me check here. You got a last name?
It's the same.
Ahmed the same? How do you pronounce that?
Let me call you back.
Ahmed the same?
No, it's not Ahmed the same. It's Ahmed. That's my first name and my last name. It's my parents.
I'll figure it out.
No, just let's correct this right now. It's Ahmed. Ahmed!
Tonight on Axis TV, straight from New York City, it's Gotham Comedy Live. Get ready to laugh with Jim McHugh, Stephanie McRae, Cisco Duran, John Moses, and your host, Ahmed Ahmed.
What's up? How you feeling, New York City, Gotham Live? You guys ready to have some fun tonight? Man, it's so nice to be here. I gotta thank you all for coming out. Before I forget, how about a big round of applause for your staff working hard for you tonight? Give it up for them. That's right. It's so nice to be here. This audience is so beautiful, so diverse, very multicultural. You know, it's nice that there's other brown people here besides me. Nice. I'm from the Middle East. Any other Arabs in here besides me? Perfect. You got one, two, three. Hey, it only takes one of us. To tell a joke. Are you guys that fucking scared? Jesus H Allah. Anybody voting for Trump?
Yeah.
You are? Fuck you. Get out. I can't support him. I'm from the Middle East, my man. Look at me. I mean, it's so funny because look at this. Middle East. They never show you images of Arabs who look like this right here. No. CNN, Fox News, they always show you Arabs just... We're not Game of Thrones. Come on, news. Show images of guys who look like me. Tall, tan, handsome, shredded. Yeah. Hashtag lifestyle. No. They just show you... Like ISIS? Anybody following ISIS? Not following ISIS. You know what I meant? Like, the group, the popular group, ISIS. Who reps them? Who's their agent? How are they so popular and dominating wars when they're driving 1968 Toyota pickup trucks? That's what I want to know. Social media, and I know why. I was watching an ISIS spokesperson talking shit to America about how they use social media to get their word out. I'll show you what he said, I wrote it down. Relax, it's not a detonator. It's an iPhone 6 Plus, bitches. So they subtitled what this guy said because he was speaking cave or whatever. But here's how it sounds like in my head. We Muslims around the world are getting the word out to other Muslims to wage a war against America. Social media has been a great help with our cause and getting the word out about ISIS. So please, like us on Facebook. Follow us on Twitter and Instagram at Super Scary Jihad. If you post a picture burning the American flag, we will retweet you. Also, please use hashtag American Pig And please use a photo of an actual pig, not a stuffed animal like these other idiots. And we prefer lo-fi or Valencia filter. Also, don't forget LOLDMFAO, laugh out loud, detonating my fucking ass off.
So, I'm just reporting the news. This is nice to come up to this warmth. See people, go back to your communities. Tell all your friends and neighbors, hey, we saw one tonight. We interacted with him, he's okay.
I enjoy being from the Middle East. It's fun, right? Okay, I'm not really Arab, I'm Mexican. This is a marketing scheme. I wanted an angle. How are you guys doing tonight? Four ladies. You're from the Middle East, you said? What part? Sudan. You're from Sudan, right next to Egypt. That's where I'm from, Egypt. First civilization known to man. You're welcome, I guess. Yeah, we built the pyramids. It wasn't the little fucking green aliens. It was... Okay, technically it was the Jews. Always taking credit for everything. Those Jews. That's okay, we designed and supervised. And if you're not laughing, you're probably a Jew. I was raised Muslim. Are you Muslim? Yeah, me too. Boo. Lock the doors. Give the terrorists weed. That's it. You want to solve the problem with terrorism? Let them get high. Yeah, open dispensaries. Right? Can you imagine a bunch of terrorists just sitting around plotting against America? Okay, tomorrow we will get the thing and go to the place. After tomorrow. Now I want pizza. Tomorrow we'll... Just smoke weed. It's a weed nation. I live in California. I got my little fake medical marijuana card. Yep, I walked right into the doctor's office, just fake limping, twitching my right eye, like, ah. The doctor looked at me, he was like, sir, I think you need medical marijuana. I was like, thank you, master, thank you. They deliver it to my house, like Domino's fucking pizza. It's awesome, greenlee.me, speedweed.com, it's awesome. You go on the website, you click on the thing, let me see, I'll take a couple grams of the purple kush. Give me 2 grams of the Smokey Robinson. Right, you hit send, 30 minutes later, a black dude with dreadlocks wearing a nurse outfit shows up with a little sandwich bag full of perfectly vacuum-packed sealed weed. It's perfectly packaged. It looks like shit you get at Trader Joe's, man. And they give you a bunch of free things, free pre-rolled joints that come in a little glass tube. I just save that for later in case of emergency, right? They give you edibles. Right? I don't fuck with the edibles. Who made up edibles? Like, when you smoke weed, you get high. And that's a nice little fucking high. You take an edible, it's like... I can't move my hand. I don't want to be like Stephen Hawking for 18 hours. I just don't. Figuring out math and science, that's not what I'm trying to do. The only time you should take an edible is if you're like flying to Australia. It's an 18-hour flight, right? If you're sitting coach, you fucking put on your seatbelts, put on an edible, you wake up 18 hours later, they're like, hey, hello, mate, you're down under. And that's that. We're about to have an awesome show tonight. You guys ready for an awesome show tonight? Come on, New York City, are you ready to have some fun tonight? I gotta tell you, I love being here. I'm honored to be here, and I want you to give yourselves a big round of applause for coming out tonight and supporting Gotham Live Comedy. Are you texting the CIA? That's what we wanna know. Who are you texting? All right, guys. Thank you very much. We'll be right back with some more comedy later on. Thank you.
Live from the Gotham Comedy Club in New York City, Jimmy Q is taking the stage when we return. And stick around later for more with Ahmed Ahmed when he returns to the stage. Welcome back to Gotham Comedy Live. More great stand-up coming your way starting right now.
All right, we're back. You guys having fun so far? We're going to move this show right along. This first comic coming into the stage is a very funny guy. You're going to see him at the Boston Comedy Festival coming up really soon. Show him some love. Mr. Jim McHugh, everybody.
All right. Wow. Hello, Gotham Live. Yeah. I'm in a really good mood. I just lost 68 pounds. Thank you. I've been stalking a jogger. When I was a kid, I used to stutter, so my father went out and bought me a parrot. He says, Jim, you teach this parrot how to speak, and you'll lose your stammer, you know? But the only thing that bird ever learned how to say was, stop mocking me. I read an article, certain types of people can get skin cancer even if they wear sunblock. People who are pale or light-skinned, people with freckles or warts, people with red hair. Why don't they just say Irish people? Why don't I change my name to Jim McMalinoma? How would that be? My hair is falling out. My wife dragged me out to one of these hair plug places. That's a real confidence builder, right? Drags me down there. They start telling me about the treatment, but all I want to know is how much is it going to cost? Finally get it out of the guy. You know what it costs? $10,000. Yeah. So I looked at my wife and said, why don't we take $5,000 and pay other women to sleep with me? I was walking over here. I seen a 400-pound guy on 35th Street. He had a Captain America T-shirt, and he did not look like Captain America. He looked like America. And parts of Canada. I think we gotta get together as a country. This politics stuff is making us too crazy. It's dividing us as people. We gotta come together, right? Yeah, I was working down in Texas and I mentioned immigration. I realized half the people wanna, you know, let everybody in the country and the other half wanna build a wall and keep everybody out. And I thought there's gotta be some kind of middle ground here, right? I think a wall is a very negative thing. Instead of building a wall, why don't we build something positive? You know, like a bridge, right? Right from Mexico to Canada. Right? Yeah. No off ramps. I read this, about 40% of the people out there have a fantasy about making love outdoors. And I read that and I thought to myself, finally, a break for the homeless. I read somewhere that 86% of women are not attracted to bodybuilders. I think that's ironic because 86% of bodybuilders are not attracted to women. Yeah. My wife likes to watch HGTV. It gives her ideas of things that I could be doing when I don't want to be doing anything at all. I hate that channel. It made her come up with this idea. She came up the other day and she said, we need to repaint that front room. Couple things wrong with that little sentence, isn't there? We, because it's gonna be me, and repaint. Guys, back me up. Why don't you paint that front room? That room has been painted. You don't repaint that room. You have to another house, you have some other idiot paint that front room. But now my wife, she wouldn't let it go. We need to repaint that front room. We need to repaint that front room. We need to repaint that front room. 3 days of this, there I am, painting the front room. You know, because it takes 7 days to get a gun permit. I'm working on the road and this guy tweets me and he says, I watch your YouTube video and I just want to let you know, I think you're hilarious and I think you're very sexy. And I said, wow, well listen, you know, I've been married to a woman for 9 years, but I'll take a compliment anywhere I can get one, you know? You know what I mean? Yeah. So then he emails me back. He says, I don't care if you're married for 9 years. You're really my type. You're a bear. And if you ever get down to like, yeah, if you ever get down to Atlanta, he says, I'll buy you drinks and take you out. So I told my wife, she says, I think it's inappropriate that once you told him you're married, he keeps hitting on you. And I said, wait a minute. We've been married for 9 years and you never tell me I'm funny or sexy. I'm keeping this guy. I like to watch the History Channel. You know, I saw a special on this guy, Pavlov, you know. For those of you who don't know, he was a behaviorist. And he won a Nobel Prize. All he did is he fed these dogs, and they would drool and salivate. And he'd ring a bell. Every day he fed the dogs. Every day they drooled. Every day they'd still, you know, drool. So one day he takes the food away, and just from the sound of the ringing bell, these dogs were conditioned to drool. He gets a Nobel Prize. And I can tell you, as a married man, that behaviorism works. Because whenever I get lucky, the next day, I clean out the gutters. Because on some behavioral level, I know about a year has gone by. Thank you. I'm glad you're laughing at that. Yeah. I did that at a college, and he looked at me like, can you live a whole year like that? Then I did one for the old folks, and they said, you do that every single year? What is wrong with you? I'm watching the news with my wife, and a story comes on, right? A 96-year-old man shoots his wife because she puts a ketchup cap on too tight. So my wife looks at me, and she goes, why would he do that? I said, I think he's too weak to strangle her. I think if you pay attention, these are pretty straightforward, honey. You guys are great. The first thing I learned about marriage, you got to learn the language, fellas. I didn't understand. My wife, when we first got married, she'd say things like, I wish somebody would take out the trash. I was like, is there somebody else here? Shouldn't we be on a first-name basis by now? I saw this on a plaque. It said there are 3 billion women in the world that don't look like supermodels. There's only 8 women in the whole world that do. And I thought to myself, ladies, you put way too much pressure on yourselves, right? You're all beautiful. You never see us guys put that kind of pressure on ourselves. You ever see us guys comparing ourselves to Tom Cruise? No, we tell you he's gay and we move on. I read an article and it said this. It said that women, I read this article, said women can save men's lives. If you're married, guys, you can reduce your chance of heart attack by 45% if you make love twice a week. So I cut that article out. I put it on the breakfast table and I waited. The next morning, my wife sits down, I give her a cup of coffee, she puts her glasses on, she reads it, and she looks up at me and she says, you have lived a full life. All right, I've been Jimmy King. You guys are awesome. Thank you so much. Thank you. Oh my God.
Live from the Gotham Comedy Club in New York City, Stephanie McCray is taking the stage when we return. Stay tuned for more laughs on Axis TV.
What's up, Gotham? Gotham Live, we're back. Gotham Comedy Live, we are back. How you feeling so far? Question for the older ladies. Where are my cougars at? That a girl. What is a cougar? I'm curious. Because I've been asking audiences all over the world. There's always an older woman that yells out from the back of the room, over 50. I'm like, that's a saber-toothed tiger. That's... over 25? You watch too much Sex in the City, my friend. All right, you guys ready to keep the show going? Make some noise. You have seen this next comedian on the Wendy Williams Show. She's funny, she's beautiful. Give it up, Stephanie McRae.
date. Okay, I see the rest of you bitches got low self-esteem. What's happening? I'm like, ladies, y'all look good. Half the building got quiet. Ladies, y'all know what that's from, though. We can't even compliment each other no more. It's the fellas' fault. You know why? Because they've been judging us for too long, right? They judge us about our hair, judge us about our makeup. Now they judge us about our bodies. Let me tell you something. I know I got a little pouch, but I'm not walking around here holding my stomach in all goddamn day because you want a bitch with a small waist. These are adult abs, goddammit. I'm over 40. I mean 3 to 4 times a day. I gotta make sure my sugar level is right. You want a bitch with a small waist? You better go get one of them 22-year-olds with the dirty bra straps. Oh, yeah. They cute. They got a nice body, but they hygiene toe up. You know, like they wiping back to front. They nasty. Look at the 22-year-olds like, get this bitch off stage. But ladies, this is the thing. We don't mess with the fellas, right? We let y'all live, because as soon as y'all gain weight, get that little pot belly, what we say? Oh, that's just man weight. No, motherfucker, your upper body look like a juice box. And then you see the dudes wear the hats all day. You know why? Because their hairline is all the way the fuck back here. Your edges is gone, sir. You need a Brazilian unit. Oh, and my favorite is these tight clothes. This trend, I hate it. Y'all see the guys with these jeans tighter than mine? But these be the first dudes running in your face, talking about, yo, when you gonna let me be your man? I'm like, nigga, never. Them tight-ass jeans on, you my homegirl. Let's go get a mani-pedi, bitch. Terrible. I know this mouth of mine. And he just got a new job, too. Yeah, I'm excited about this new job, but the thing about it is, you know, you get your new hire paperwork and you get a new job. I forgot to fill out my new hire paperwork and choose my doctor on my health insurance, so they chose a doctor for me. Got my health insurance cards in the mail the other day. Primary care doctor is Dr. Toe. Good Asian doctor, I know, because I had a Dr. Toe before. But my GYN, Dr. Deshaun P. Johnson. I was like, hell no, ain't nobody named Deshaun fucking around with my vagina. Like, I know a Deshaun, all right? Deshaun should be cheating on me right now, right? Like a Deshaun should be fucking my credit up, not down there judging my goddamn vagina. And I was confused anyway. I was like, what happened to Sanjay Gupta? He wasn't available? They couldn't find a Dr. Patel nowhere in my network. Terrible. It's terrible. It's so racist. but I'm single now. I'm single. I'm excited. I got any single people out here? Yes. We're relationship people there. Relationship people, make some noise. All right. All 10 of y'all, kill yourselves. Fuck y'all and y'all happy-ass relationship. Because I feel like relationship people like to mess with our self-esteem, right? And I see this cute little couple over here. I see y'all. I also seen his ass on Tinder. Hey, Dave. 3 miles away, you made it. I don't know, but I feel like being single in the city is tough because I feel like guys, y'all have like a guy code. Because single ladies, you ever meet a guy, tell him you single, and he asks you that famous-ass question? Why are you single? Like I'm a snitch on myself. Like I'm gonna say, cause I key cars, cut tires, and go through cell phones, I'm crazy. It's true. But I'm not gonna tell you that. It's none of your business that I'm on 187 milligrams of Paxil a day. All you need to know is I'm cute and I'm available Friday, 8 p.m. And if you don't show up, I'ma kill your shit. One dude gonna say to me, Stephanie, you ain't got to worry about killing my shit because I ain't got no car. I was like, yeah, well, I fuck your Metro card up. So I tear that transfer up in 19 goddamn pieces. Don't play with me. I'm crazy. I don't know. I just got out of a marriage, so things are different now. Like, so I'm dating this dude, and I've been dating him for a while. And he's at the point where now he wants to take it to another level. Yeah, so he asked me to do some real weird shit with him last week. He asked me to take a shower with him. Oh, y'all look confused. Y'all think because I'm black, I don't want to get my hair wet. Has nothing to do with that. I can't properly wash my ass in front of a man. Because come on, ladies, y'all know we got to throw the leg up on the soap dish, right? Act like we grating cheese. That's not sexy. You can't do that in front of no man. Like, how can you properly wash the crack of your ass in front of a man? Come on, ladies, y'all know we gotta wrap the rag around the middle finger and get up in the asshole. What if you got a white rag? Shit happens. All right, for you ladies that ain't laughing, you ain't washing your ass right. Right? Shit is just so different for me. And this is the thing about being my age, about being over 40, because I have a very youthful spirit. But I meet a lot of younger people, and that's cool. But the thing is when I tell you who I am, respect that and act accordingly. I met this dude by the train station, right? We exchanged telephone numbers. By the time I got off the train and got back to my house, he was already texting me. Like, yo, why don't you send me a picture? I'm like, I just saw you. Right? But the next morning, he sent me a picture of his penis at 7 o'clock in the morning. I get to work 2 hours later, 9 a.m., he come calling me, tell me, hey, babe, did you get my picture? I was like, yeah, I got your picture. He was like, well, why don't you send me something of yourself? But I'm like, we're Facebook friends. I have 99,000 pictures on Facebook. You don't like none of those? He was like, nah, I want you to send me something a little bit more intimate. So I was like, all right. I sent him a picture of myself in the third grade. Y'all remember that pose? With the gray background and the clouds? I think it was package A. Ladies, this dude called me back 30 minutes later with an attitude. Talk about, yo, why would you send me a picture of yourself in the third grade? I was like, wait a minute, nigga. You sent me a picture of yourself in the third grade? Been amazing crowd. My name is Stephanie McCray. Thank you so much. Thank you.
Live from the Gotham Comedy Club in New York City, Cisco Duran is taking the stage when we return. Stay tuned for more laughs on Axis TV. Welcome back to Gotham Comedy Live. More great stand-up coming your way starting right now.
All right. Welcome back. You guys having fun so far? Make some noise. How about this table over here, you guys, the cast from Slumdog Millionaire. How are you guys? And your chaperone. That's awesome. That's awesome. Welcome to our American comedy show. This is, I can say that, we're both brown. Even the black people were like, that's fucked up, motherfucker. Some fucked up shit. We're gonna keep this show going. Make some noise if you wanna hear some more comedy in New York City. And you're gonna love this next guy. You will see him on Comedy Central really soon. Very funny. Show him some love, Mr. Cisco Duran.
What up, New York? Wait, we could do a lot better than that. How you guys doing? You guys good? Not a lot of fat people in here. Not a lot of fat people. I noticed that. I don't think New York likes fat people. I really don't think you guys do. Because there's a lot of sidewalks, a lot of stairs, the bathroom's small as shit. Like, I think the motto for New York should be fuck fat people. I think that's what it should be. But this thing, I know why I got fat. I really do. Because I've been eating McDonald's for a long time. I love McDonald's. I really do. The only thing I don't like about McDonald's is waiting in line. Because, like, some people take forever to order. Like, I was in McDonald's not too long ago. There was this black guy. He was three guys ahead of me. I swear to God, he was like this, right? He was like, I was like, sir, you don't know what you want to order? He was like, not yet, though, cuz. Not yet, though. I was like, sir, you don't know what you want to order? Because it's been the same fucking menu for 20 years, okay? Like, you guys know the McDonald's menu, right? The number one's a Big Mac for $5.30. The number two's a quarter pounder for $6.10. The number three's a double quarter pounder for $6.80. The number four is a big and tasty for $5.60. Now, if you live in the ghetto, the number four is really a two cheeseburger meal for $4.10. All right, there's a few ghetto people here. I see that. All right, that's cool. White lady, I apologize about this joke. I know you go to Chick-fil-A or whatever. So the black guy, sort of guy, black guy's like this. He's like, yeah. Hey, let me get that number four with a fudge sundae. Hey, and put some sprinkles on it. Hey, does anybody know what the fuck a sprinkle is? No, I don't know what it is either. I don't know. I'll ask him. Hey, sir, what's a sprinkle? He was like, that's the topping you put on top of an ice cream, cuz. I was like, oh, you mean sprinkles? I think the first K is silent, I'm not sure. And if you didn't laugh at that, you didn't graduate high school. Then this white dude right after him, right? This white guy who was like, yes. Can I get the fish filet? Which is the number 11. And throw in some sprinkles like the black guy. That was really racist, I apologize about that. This is the thing. Like, I'm really weird. I'm really fucked up in the head because it's my parents' fault. Like, I grew up different. I grew up Jehovah's Witness, right? Like, I'm not Jehovah's Witness now. I'm not knocking on your doors on Sunday. What's even weirder is, like, I saw my dad's dick one time, right? Let me explain. My dad pees with the door wide open. He never closes the door. I walked in on him peeing. I looked at him. I was like, oh, my God, Dad, you have a really big Johnson. And he pulled up his pants, he walked out, and he was like, son, don't worry about it. One day you'll have a big dick just like mine. All right, this was last week, which makes it really weird about the guy. And I watch way too much porno. It really messed me up in my head, it really has. I do, I love porno. Like, you like porno, sir? Yeah, what's your favorite kind of porno? What do you like to watch? Don't look around, look at me, okay? I want you... What do you like to watch? The random pick, just whatever the box show. I like that. See, don't look at him weird because listen, we watch porno, it's something that we don't regularly get, okay? Like I watch porno in Spanish because they refer to the genital area as food. I don't know if you guys seen it. Like I was watching this Mexican chick today, I swear to God, she was like this. She was like, ay, papi, ay, dame tu burrito. And I'm like, yes! I love Taco Bell, it's delicious. Which is the number four on their menu. I jack off too much too. Like you ever do this, sir? You ever jack off and you know you're home alone? And then you hear a noise and freak out and stop, but it was just the ice maker? That ever happened to you? Don't say no, dude. It's happened to every dude in here, okay? Every dude's been home and they're like, oh yeah. Oh my. Hello? That's why it's hard for me to date women, man. It really is hard. But I'm with this Cuban chick, right? Her family's really racist, but I'm with this Cuban chick. But before her, like, I was very picky with the kind of women I like to date. Like, I don't like dating skinny chicks. I like dating chubby chicks that get me. And some of you guys are looking at me weird. I'll give you an example, okay? If I was to take a skinny girl out to eat versus a chubby chick, I take a skinny girl out to eat. I like eating pizza. We'll go get some pizza. We get down to the last slice of pizza. The skinny chick's gonna look at me and she's gonna be like, hey, babe, do you want the last slice of pizza? Now look at me, guys. We all know that I want the last slice of pizza. It's not a mystery. But I can't look like a fat ass, so I gotta be like, nah, babe, I don't want the last slice of pizza. You can have it. I'm not hungry. And then I'll get mad because she'll box it up and take it home. Same scenario with the chubby chick. We go get some pizza, we get down to the last slice. The chubby chick's gonna look at me and she's gonna be like, hey, babe, I'm gonna go order more pizza. Is that okay with you? All right. Some of you guys look confused. I'll give you another example. Sex with the skinny chick versus a chubby chick. Skinny chick, we wake up in the morning, she's gonna be like, babe, last night was amazing. I want you to know that. Hey, listen, usually in the morning I go outside, I jog, I exercise for a bit. Do you want to join me this morning? No. Same scenario with the chubby chick. We wake up in the morning, she's gonna be like, babe, last night was amazing. I want you to know that. Hey, listen, I'm gonna go order more pizza. Is that okay with you? The only problem me and chubby chicks is this. Two fat people, it's really difficult to have sex with each other, all right? I'm serious, it's like two basketballs. The parts really don't reach each other. No, because there's only like three positions you could do. Okay, I'll tell you. You got doggy style. You got missionary at the edge of the bed. Think about it. And you have scissoring. Those are the only options you have. And I'm not saying this because I didn't try to have sex with a big girl. It's not the case. I had sex with this big girl. She was on top of me, riding me. She wanted me to talk dirty to her. She was on top. She was like, baby, talk dirty to me. And I wasn't saying anything. And she was like, baby, talk dirty to me. And I still wasn't saying anything, so she stopped. She was like, why aren't you talking dirty to me? I'm like, because I'm trying to breathe. So I sent her a text message like, you like that bitch? Smiley face. But I'm not gonna lie. I'm really trying to lose weight, though. I really am. Like, I've lost 100 pounds from last year to this year. I'm really trying to do good. Yeah. But this is the thing, though. I got diagnosed with pre-diabetes, right? And I went up to my friend. I was like, hey, what should I do to lose weight? He was like, Cisco, you just need to change the way you eat. You change the way you eat, you'll be fine. What you need to do is you need to go to Whole Foods. Whole Foods has organic fruits and vegetables. It's really good for you. Change the way you eat, you'll be great. So I went to Whole Foods for the first time in my life. I got a shopping cart and put fruits and vegetables in my shopping cart. Then I got to the cash register. And I tried paying with my credit card and it got declined for suspicious activity. So, you guys have been amazing, New York. Thank you guys so much. You guys have a great night.
Live from the Gotham Comedy Club in New York City, John Moses is taking the stage when we return. Stay tuned for more laughs on Axis TV.
Welcome back, Gotham Comedy Live. How y'all feeling? I want to acknowledge our crew that's working around you guys. Killer Bunny Productions, give it up for these guys working hard for you tonight. Right? And let's not forget the Mazzelli brothers who own this place and are producers of the show. Chris Mazzelli, Steve Mazzelli. Yeah. We're about to wrap it up here with our final comic. I'm just curious, who's from Jersey? Who said they were from Jersey? Nice. Here's some money for the subway. I'm kidding. I take Uber. We started the show with a white comic. We're gonna end it with a white comic. Interesting how life works out. Hey, when you're white, you're right. I wish I was white. I feel like I am because I have credit. Yeah, I make my bed. White people make their beds. Google it. The fucking Asian guy's laughing. It's fine. You guys ready for our last comic? Make some noise. New York City, you are in for a treat. This next comedian has his second comedy album coming out called Upper Middle Trash. Available on iTunes May 6th. Check it out. Show him some love, Mr. John Moses.
Now there's a Muslim you can feel safe around, right, guys? The Trump guy just went, nope. That's how they trick you, dummy. I'm from Canada originally. Hold your applause. And when people find out I'm from Canada, they automatically assume that I'm like this ultra-liberal apologetic dude. I'm not really that guy, man. I used to be a little more liberal 15 years ago when I was in college and my head was filled with weed and cotton candy. But then I drank my way out of there and stumbled to the right a little bit, but I'm still very much in the center. Case in point. I absolutely believe 100% without a doubt that gays should be able to marry. You love that dude? You want to marry him? Go ahead. You're already doing the disgusting part. Why would I try and cock block a beautiful ceremony, right? Oh, someone got tricked. Now, when I say disgusting part, obviously I'm talking about the dudes. I'm a big fan of chick-on-chick action. That's what I think heaven is. You get to the pearly gates and it's just lesbian angels floating by, 69ing each other. The heavy ones on the bottom because it's heaven and it's fair, right? Who wouldn't want to see that? The Pope himself would want to see that. Especially the new cool guy. But I bet you secretly, popes across time would want to watch. Like the Pope 200 years ago would burst in on two women in a room with his team of lesbian witch hunters and be like, burn those witches! I'm like, wait. Let them finish. Yeah, get in there. Enjoy your last supper, ladies. It's the last meal you're gonna get. Oh, I'm racist. Anybody else? I knew I could count on you guys, man. Now, when I say I'm racist, this is what I'm talking about, man. On the scale of racism, I think everybody's on it. You just gotta figure out where. I'm to the right of center a little bit. You go all the way to the right, that's where you get your maniacs, Muslim extremists, ultra-Orthodox Jews, Klans members, Mel Gibson, Kanye, all those maniacs way over there. And then, like, the middle of the right is Fox News and Al Sharpton, Home Team Boys, you know? To the right of center a little bit's me and Charles Barkley, and we're just talking shit. We're talking shit. We'll hang out with anybody, but you're gonna hear some shit getting talked. And then to the left of center is my wife, because she's a bit of a naive dummy when it comes to racism. But then you go all the way to the left, and you get these hyper-liberal pussy idealists that are so full of shit, they don't know they're racist to begin with, right? Guys like Matt Lauer, who have a fucking heart attack every time some old, rich, white racist drops an N-bomb, right? Like, he's like, I can't believe they said that, right? Because he hangs out with Al Roker at the Christmas party, and occasionally bumps into Hootie at a Whole Foods. Fuck off. I was doing this show in Connecticut, country club, all white crowd. The fucking assholes in this place were welded shut. They were so uptight, they're just like... I was the wrong guy for that show. And then at the end of the show, this woman comes up to me and she was like 55, but spent a lot of her husband's money to look 45. And her hair smelled like $400. And she was like this, she went... And she was so uptight, even her mouth looked like a little baby asshole. She was like... And she went, that was racist. And I said, oh, fuck off. You live 175 miles away from the nearest NBA franchise, and I'm racist? Have you ever lived beside a Mexican family that plays music till 3 o'clock in the morning on a Tuesday to celebrate their 5-year-old son's birthday party? Because if you haven't, how do you know you don't hate Mexicans? You gotta live with some people in order to understand how this shit works, right? I just moved to Jersey 6 months ago, and when people from New York hear that, they're like, why would you move to Jersey? Like I moved in Newark Penn Station or something, and I'm kicking away pigeons. No, I live in like a nice white dope part of Jersey, right? But when I lived in New York, my dudes was a black dude and a Mexican Jew. That was my crew. That's how I rolled. I wasn't trying to fill any quotas or anything. They're just funny dudes, right? Now, in truth, the Mexican Jew is actually a Puerto Rican Jew. But this is what I've learned about Latinos since my time in New York. Latinos are racist towards other Latinos. So whatever Latino you're talking to, they think they're at the top of the pile, boy. So if they're from Argentina, we've got the Pope. If they're from Colombia, it's like Coke and Folgers or whatever they do. The only thing they can agree on is that Mexicans are definitely at the bottom. Not my rule. I'm from fucking Canada. If you're speaking Spanish, you're a Mexican as far as I'm concerned. I didn't even know where Puerto Rico was on a map until I was 28. My buddy was like, I'm from Puerto Rico. I was like, oh, that's cool. Is that like outside of Cancun? I've been there. That was nice. Does it have a Senor Frogs? I don't know. Now, you might see us hanging out. I still hang out with them when I'm in New York. They can't drive to Jersey until they get their license straight. But when I'm in New York and we're hanging out, you might see us and be like, oh, those guys aren't racist. Wrong. Hanging out with them makes me more racist because it exposes me to situations where I'm the only white guy in the room or the only white guy at a cookout. And when you're the only white guy at a cookout, you feel like an extra in a Spike Lee joint. Some old woman's putting salad on a plate. She's like, hey, white boy, you want some salad? I know you guys are always trying to live forever. Here, take that salad and get out of the sun. Get out of the sun. You burning up, baby. You burning up. Get under the tree where it's shady and you safe. You need an SPF? What do you need, like a 666? You look like the devil, motherfucker. Why the fuck am I here? You don't think you're racist, here's the test. Next time you're at the airport, and you see a Muslim dude at your gate, real deal Muslim dude, not some suave looking motherfucker like Ahmed. No, like, Ahmed's father, Ahmed. You see Ahmed? You see that fucking dude? With a bedsheet pajama suit on, looking like a villain from Aladdin? Tell me you don't start thinking about how you're gonna save the plane. I know better. I know better, and I get all Marky Mark. I'm like, not on my plane, motherfucker. About to put my dick in this chick's face. Guy's not a fucking terrorist. He's a refugee from Krapistan. He's trying to get the fuck out of there before he gets blown up. Doesn't even matter though, man. Whether you think you're racist or not, it doesn't even matter. Because Latinos are gonna be running this shit in the next 40 years anyway. Suck it up. Learn the language. Buy Rosetta Stone. Nothing you can do to stop it. Nothing you can do to stop it. They can put up a giant electric fence along the Mexican-American border and they'll be running their ACs off it with jumper cables as they catapult people through the air. You think Arizona's got a problem now? Wait till it's hailing pregnant Mexican ladies. Well, I've had fun. Before I get out of here, just want to say R.I.P. Prince, you up in the heavens, purple raining down on all of our hearts. All of our hearts! Thank you very much. Yo, buy my album, motherfuckers.
Live from the Gotham Comedy Club in New York City, Ahmed Ahmed is taking the stage when we return. Stay tuned for more laughs on Access TV.
Thank you guys for coming out. Gotham Comedy Live. How about a hand for Jim McHugh, Stephanie McRae, Cisco Duran, John Moses. Thank you guys. Thank you. Thank you, New York City. Make some noise.